Hey everyone, so welcome to my playlist on single variable calculus. In last lecture, we talked about the concept of global maxima and the global minima of a function. Today, we are going to talk about the concept of local extreme values. That means the concept of local maxima and local minima for a given function. And then we will see its connection with global maxima and minima. And at the end, we will see a very nice theorem that connects extreme values with the derivative of a function. So this is what the agenda is. So let us start by looking at the graph. Now if you look at this graph, you can see that the function has a domain in the interval, closed interval a to b. Okay, at point c you can see that this is the topmost point. So this is my, if I call this as my f of c, so you can see that your f of c is greater equal f of x, because it is the topmost point, and as we saw in my last lecture, this is the global maximum for the function at the point c. And what is the global minimum? This, if I call this as f of d, then this is global minimum. That means what? Your f of d is less equal f of x for all x belongs to this domain. Okay, now but if you see, if I call this as my point E, now point E is not that bad. Okay, obviously at point E, we are not having the global maximum because global maximum is here. But then if I restrict myself, suppose in this interval, suppose I restrict myself in this open interval means what? These endpoints are not included. So if I restrict myself in this open interval, then if I see for this interval, my points will be these points. It will be only this much, right? Then if you observe in this interval, this E is acting as a maximum value. That means what I'm saying is your f of E, let me take white chalk, is greater equal f of x for all x belongs to I. Now what is my I? I is this interval. Interval containing E, correct? Because in this part only this much, here I am having the maximum value. So this is called as the local maximum value for the function. Okay, so even though there are points where you are not having the maximum value, global maximum, but if you restrict yourself, or in other words, if there exists, or if you are able to find an interval containing the point such that this inequality holds over that interval, open interval, then we say that at point E, function is having the local maximum value. So this is my f of E. F of E is the local maximum value. A function can have more than one maximum value. Like if you take this point, if I call this point as h, then for this h also, if I restrict myself in this interval, that means from here to here, if you look only this much of the curve, then what? This f of h is the local maximum value. That means what? Your f of h is greater equal f of x for all x belongs to, let me call j. What is j? J is this interval. So whenever you are able to find an interval, open interval, okay, not closed, open interval containing that point such that this inequality holds, then such points, at such points, function will have the local maximum value. And the same concept goes for the local minimum as well. That's why the word local, because this is maximum locally, not globally, but only locally. Okay, so that is one thing. And similarly, you can see if I take this point, suppose if I take this point over here, so let me erase this. So if I call this point as say k, okay, and if I restrict myself, suppose in this interval, so let me take a different chalk. If I restrict myself in this interval, that means from here to here, so this is the graph, right? Then at k, function, so we know that at d we are having the global minimum, but if I restrict myself in this interval, then at k I am having what? Local minimum value. Similarly, if I call this point as say m, then at m also, if I take this interval, then this is acting as the local minimum. Well, you can take this interval. If you want, you can take this interval as well. Okay, but you can't take interval for this point M. You can't take interval from here to here, right? You can't take this interval for the point M, because for this interval, this is not the minimum value. D is coming into picture, so this is the minimum value. Okay, so this interval will not work, the bigger one. But if I restrict myself to this small interval, then yes, at M I am having the local minimum value for the given function. Okay, so that is the concept of local maxima and local minimum. Okay, so globally it is not maximum, but it may happen that if you choose some small neighborhoods, then in that neighborhoods, or you can say in that interval, function is having maximum or the minimum value. Okay, so whenever you open any standard book, you will see the definition as, at point C, a function is having maximum, local maximum value if there exists an open interval containing that point such that the inequality holds over that interval. Then we say that it's local maximum, and same for the local minimum. Okay, now what is the connection between local maximum or the local extreme value and the global extreme value? Let's try to see that. So now this is some graph. Now from here you can see at C we are having global maxima. So f of c is what is the global maximum. That means what? Your f of c is greater equal f of x for all x belongs to interval, close interval a b. So c is the point where function is having global maximum value or absolute maximum value. Now question is, will this c will also act as the local maximum value? Answer is yes. So when something will act as a local maximum, if you can give me some interval where this inequality holds, if you give me some open interval containing c where this inequality holds, so yes, why not? If I say f of c greater equal f of x for all x belongs to open interval ab, right? So if I take this as my interval, then in this interval, is c maximum value? Yes. So therefore, if you have the global maximum, then that will also act as a local maximum. Okay, so at c, if you have a global maximum value, then at c it is also the local maximum value. Okay, so one can make this statement that if the global extreme values exist, then the local extreme values also exist. Okay, but otherwise not true. Like if this is the local max, you can see this is the local maxima. Is this the global maxima? No, right? Because over the whole interval at C we are having the maximum value. Okay, so the points where we are having global maxima, then that can also be looked as the local maxima. But the points where we are having local maxima, that cannot be looked as the points where we are having global maxima, because global maxima is always this, it's unique. Okay, so I hope this relation is clear to you. If you at some point, if you are having global extreme values, then those can be considered as the local extreme values as well, because we can always find an interval, open interval. But otherwise not true. If at some points you are having local extreme values, then that may need not be considered as a global extreme values. Like here at h we are having local maximum value, but this is not global maximum value. Okay, so I hope the concept is clear. Now let's try to see the connection between the extreme values and the derivative of a function. Okay, so if you have observed my last lecture until now, this lecture, wherever the graph which I have drawn, then if you have observed that wherever you had global maxima or the global minima or the local maxima or the local minima, here you always had this bump kind of thing, right? This is always what you have observed. Okay, so now, and you can see this is a smooth one, that means it's a differentiable function because there is no sharp corners. No sharp points, such thing is not there, sharp points. I have talked about the sharp points. Wherever, whenever you have a sharp points in the picture, at those points function is not differentiable. If you are not aware of that, you can see my lecture on differentiability. Okay, so this is what we have. Now what I want to say is, at some point if you are having say local maxima or the local minima, in this case minima, and if the derivative exists, that means it's the smooth curve, then the slope of the tangent line at e comma f of e, what is this point, e comma f of e, then the slope of the tangent line is zero. What is the slope of the tangent line? Means the derivative at point e. Okay, so let with this connection let me write this as c over here. Now at c I am having the local minimum value, right? Because in this interval it is acting as a minimum value. So if I draw the tangent line at c comma f of c, if I call this as point p, what is my point p? It is c comma f of c. Then you can see that the tangent line is horizontal. And what is the slope of the horizontal lines? If you have an horizontal line, that means a line which is parallel to x-axis, then the slope is always zero. Because my y1 and y2 are same. What is the slope? Y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Since y1 and y2 are same, it's a horizontal line, not change in y. Therefore, the slope is zero. So whenever you have a local maxima or local minima, and if the derivative is well defined, that means the derivative exists, then the derivative has to be zero. It has no other choice. Okay, you can see anywhere, wherever you have maximum minima, you can see the slope of the tangent line is zero. That means what? The tangent line is always parallel to x-axis. So whenever you have this thing, these two things, local extreme exist and the derivative is well defined, then the derivative has to be zero. Okay, so one more thing over here. Your f dash of c has to be well defined, then only you can talk about the derivative is zero. If f dash of c is not well defined, that means what? If the derivative does not exist, then you can't say that the derivative is zero, right? For example, this graph at point c, I am telling the maximum value, but thus can I say that derivative at c is zero? Answer is no. Why? Because this is a sharp point and the derivative does not exist at the sharp points. I have talked about this in my differentiability lecture. Links you can find in the description. So therefore we need this f dash is well defined. Then only you can say the derivative is zero. So now let's try to prove this fact. So what I will do is, I will prove the case for maxima. The same proof will work for the minima. So that I will give you as a homework. You can give a try. Now what I want to prove, the derivative at this point is zero. Now what is f dash of c? If you can recall the definition, it is limit x approaching to c, f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. This is the definition. And when does the limit exist? When your right hand limit and the left hand limit exist. That means what? Limit x approaching to c minus my left hand limit, which is x f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. This is equal to my right hand limit, which is x approaching c plus f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. And we know that this is called as my left hand derivative because I am approaching c from left hand side, and this thing is called as my right hand derivative. So when does the derivative exist? When the left hand derivative is equal to right hand derivative. So it is given to me that these two things are equal, and that's what my derivative is. And we have to use this fact one by one. So let's use the left hand derivative first, and then we will use the right hand derivative. Okay, so proof is very straightforward. So my derivative is equal to left hand derivative, L means left hand derivative. What is this? This is limit x approaching to c minus f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. Okay, now look over here. This is my c. I am approaching c from left hand side. So these are my x. That means my x is less than c. That means what? My x minus c is less than 0. That means what? This denominator is negative. What is given to me? At c I am having local extreme value. Okay, we are assuming maxima. So at c I am having local maximum value. That means what? Your f of c is greater equal f of x. For the neighborhood, small neighborhood of c, we have this inequality. That means what? F of x minus f of c is less equal 0. That means what? This is also negative. So your numerator and denominator both are negative. That means the ratio will become positive, and limit of any positive thing is always greater equal 0. So my left hand derivative is greater equal 0. But my f dash of c is also equal to right hand derivative. It is also equal to my right hand derivative. Why? Because the derivative exists. So this is also equal to right hand derivative. This is limit x going to c plus
f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. Now I know that the numerator is negative. What about x minus c? Now x is approaching c from right hand side. That means what? My x is greater than c. That means what? My x minus c is positive. So this is negative, this is positive, so the ratio is negative, and therefore limit has to be less equal 0. So therefore your f dash of c, at one end we are getting it is greater equal 0, and at one end we are getting it is less equal 0. It's a real number that is sandwiched between two zeros. Then what can you say about such number? Then f dash of c has to be 0, right? It can be positive, it can be negative, because it is lying between zeros. So thus, if at a point you are having local maxima and the derivative is well defined, then the derivative has to be 0. So this is what the connection is between the local extreme values and the derivative of a function. So I hope you understood the concept of local extreme value, its connection with global extreme value, and the connection of extreme values and the derivative. So if everything is clear, then please do not forget to like, share and subscribe. And if you have any doubt, then you can ask me in the comment section. Okay, but before that, this part you have to do as a homework. I have done the thing for maxima, local maxima. You have to do the things for local minima. And when you do that, here it will be less equal 0 and here it will be greater equal 0. And then you can conclude your proof. Okay, so that you can give a try. But if you get stuck, then you can ask me in the comment section. Okay, have a nice day. Thank you.